Hello students, in today's class we shall be looking for the next poem, that is Television, written by Roald Dahl. So without any delay, let us begin the class. First of all, in short, we will discuss about your poet Roald Dahl. So he is one of the most prolific of modern writers in English. He was a British novelist, short story writer and a poet. He also worked as fighter pilot and has large fair of following among young readers. So he was one of the most famous writers of 20th century. And now we will going to have introduction of the poem. Here Mr. Dahl's Television is a poem that represents television as an idiot box, which makes people aware of its ill effects on children's mental growth and imagination. Okay, so here this poem Television takes a comic look at a serious problem among children today. It says that television is an idiot box which always makes people aware of its ill effect, as it stops the mental power and imagination power of the children. Okay, this poem on the other hand focuses on the goodness of reading books. The poem Television is taken from his collection Revolting Rhymes. Okay, Revolting Rhyme is the collection of this poet, and Television is one of the work which is written by him. So it is a stinging satire on television. In this poem he points out how TV crushes the creativity and spontaneity of children. So here we will study how television is going to crush the creativity and the spontaneity of the children. Before having text, we will have signpost of the poem. So here there are some points I have mentioned, you can see on your screen, that here poet advises the parents to never let their children watch television or not to install at all. The bad effects of watching television: children loll and slope around, they keep staring at TV screen and do not indulge in any productive work. So here, as I told you, that they become dull while seeing television, they become lazy, loll and slope around, and so that they are very eager to see television screen and they are not going to indulge any productive work while seeing television. So here in the next point, he says television hypnotizes the children and keeps them occupied all over the outside activities. This proves convenient to the parents that the television is represented as a monster that kills imagination and ruins their senses. So children's imagination and their senses can be killed by the monster television. So he called monster to a television set. Okay, the poet also reminds the parents that in his day children entertained themselves by reading books. They were not using television. The poet appeals to the parents to replace their monstrous TV sets with bookshelves filled with lots of books. The children will object to it, but the poet is certain of the fact that sooner or later they will turn to book reading to pass their time. So he was certain that sooner or later the children will be getting the proper idea while replacing, means the way the parents are going to replace, they will be having the proper idea that yes, that will be only the benefit thing for themselves, reading a book. So the journey of reading a book that they will embark upon will never be ending and full of joy. So here it says that once they will start reading books, they will, you know, enjoy it more and more. They will find that they will have a new types of journey in their life. So the children will finally thank to their parents for this deed. Okay, what their parents have done for them, they will thank for them for their parents. So here are the student the lines of the poem. Please open your book if you have not opened. So we will go through the lines one by one. So see, here the first line says, the most important thing we've learned so far as children are concerned, इट्स नेवर 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 लेट द नियर और नियर योर टेलीविजन सेट और बेटर स्टिल डोंट जस्ट डोंट इंस्टॉल एनी द इडियोटिक थिंग एट ऑल. सो हियर इज सेइंग दैट द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग दैट वी हैव टू लर्न टू द पेरेंट्स इज अपीलिंग पेरेंट्स दैट द पोट एट द माउथ माउथ पीस ऑफ नंबर ऑफ पीपल एंड ही बिगिन्स बाई सेइंग दैट You know, the most important thing that they have no regarding children is that they should never be allowed to watch television, okay? Never be allowed to watch television. Moreover, a better situation to be, to the problem would be not to install television in their homes, okay? In the first place. So here he is saying that it is better not to install it. Next he says, In almost every houses we have been, we have watched them gaping at the screen. They loll and slope and lounge about and stare until their eyes pop out. So in this line, the poet speaks as if he has undertaken a long research of bad effects of watching television by visiting a large number of houses. Okay, means each and every houses as it is mentioned here. So, in almost every household, TV was found and the children were lazy about all day. They were staring at television screen without doing any productive work. Okay, without doing any productive work. So, here the poet indulges in a bit of exaggeration that is amusing when he says that something children are stare. You know, children are stare so hard that their eyeballs fall off, and he had seen a dozen of eyeballs rolling about on the floor of one house. So he visited a number of houses and then he found that situation clear how the children are gazing to the TV screen. Next is they sit and stare and stare and sit until they hypnotizes by it, until they are absolutely drunk with all that shocking ghastly junk. Oh yes, we know it keeps them still. They don't climb out of the window still. They never fight or kick or punch. They leave you free to cook the lunch. So here the children get so hypnotized by watching television, okay? The television make them hypnotized, as it says here, that it make them hypnotized, okay? That all they do is sit and stare at television. Their mind gets filled with all the junk, okay? With all the junk that is being telecast on television. So the only benefit that the television has is that it keeps children occupied, and the children don't fight and let their parents complete their household chores peacefully. And they never fight to kick on punch. So here at the same time the poet asks question the parents if they are aware to the bad effect television had on their children. So these can be seen, the bad effect, how the children can control or the children are controlled by television. To wonder just what this done to your beloved tortoise, the children, okay? It roots the senses in the head. It kills imagination dead. It clogs and clutters up the mind. It makes a child so dull and blind. So he can no longer understand a fantasy of fairy land. So here you can see that these lines are written in capital letter. Here you can see that these lines are written in capital letter to emphasize that watching too much television has negative impact on children. It not only clogs their minds and detroits their senses, but kills their imaginative and creativity faculty. So with them, you know, television makes them dull and restrict. See, they make them dull and completely blind to see the productive works what they can do by their imagination. So children can only see because the television set takes away their ability to think. Clear? so they cannot think even what is fantasy or a fairy land. Again, in capital letter, it focuses that his brain becomes as soft as cheese and his power of thinking rusts and freeze when he cannot think and only sees. So his thinking power will be stopped while seeing television. All right, you will cry. All right, you will say, what if we take the sets away? That what shall we do to entertain our jarring television? Please explain. So here in these lines, the poet anticipates the parents' question, asking him that even if they took the set away, what type of entertainment they would give to their children to keep them occupied. He is asking to explain. So we will answer this by asking you, what used to darling ones to do? See that here is written how they used to keep themselves content before the monster television was invented. So before that, how they were satisfied, or they were happy, they were enjoying themselves. So have you forgotten? Don't you know? We will say it very loud or slow. They read slow. They used to read, they'd read and read and read and read, then they proceed to read some more. Great Scott Gadsooks, one half of their lives was reading books. So student, here in these lines, the poet reminds the parents that before invention of television, children would read only book. They only read book and they only read book. How he has focused in these lines, okay? So books could be found everywhere. Where? On the nursery shelves. See that it is written here. On the book could be found everywhere, or the nursery shelf, or in the bedroom, or in the children's bed. So everywhere there is books before invention of television. Clear? See, such wondrous, fine and fantastic tale of dragons, gypsies, queen and whales, and the treacherous Iceland distant and shores, where smugglers rolled with muffled oars, and pirates wearing purple pants, and cannibals crouching round the pot, staring away at something hot. It smells so good, what can it be? Good, graceful, it's panoply. The younger ones had Beatrix Potter with Mr. Toad the Dirty Rotter, and Squirrel Nut King. So here you can see these lines. Here the poet gives, here you in these lines, from here to here, you can see that here the poet's gives, you know, short list. Poet's gives a short list. Short list of books. Okay. Short lists of books children used to read before invention of TV. So they used to read the books which were filled with tales of treasures. Here you can see the book which is filled by tales of treasures and shores. Okay, voyages, smugglers and pirates. See that pirates, sailing ships. Okay, pirates and then sailing ships. And elephant and cannibals is written here. See, so the story of elephant and cannibals. And the poet also refers to typical story that the children read in his days, and also used to read the tales of Mr. Toad, Squirrel, Nut King, Pit King. See that here is written all these animals characters. Yeah, that animals character, you can see that. Just wait, Mr. Toad, and then after Squirrel, Pigling, Mrs. Tiggy, the Camel, the Monkey, and Mr. Toad, Mr. Rat, and Mr. Mole. So these are the character animals character children have read in their childhood. So these can be read with the help of book only. So with the, you know, reading, by reading they can read all the things, all types of different stories and different things from their book. Now again he says, so please, oh please, we beg, we pray, go throw your TV sets away, and in this place you can install a lovely bookshelf on the wall. They filled the cells with lots of books.
ignoring all the dirty looks. What types of looks? The scream and yells, the bites and kicks, the children hitting you with the sticks. So here in these lines, the writer is talking about that by using these words like, you know, see the words, you can see here, please, beg and pray. He sincerely appeals to the parents to throw away their TV sets and they can replace them with bookshelves. Children would throw tantrums to protest, but ignoring all the children protests, they can fill a lots of book in the shelf so that they can read. Again, he says, fear not, because we promise you that in about a week or two of having nothing else to do, okay, when it's starting of the days, they will not feel good as they are very free. They don't have television to see. So they are very free not to do any work. But finally, when the time of the time will pass, they will now begin to feel the need of having something to read. Okay. But certainly, once the children would start reading, it would fill their heart with joy. They themselves would wonder why they had ever liked watching the repulsive television. Okay. So here he's saying that once they will start reading the books, they will feel that they are having some wondrous experience, wondrous joy, and they themselves will think that why they have wasted their time to watching that ridiculous machine, ridiculous thing. Okay. And later the children would love these parents. See that they would love their parents, so that whatever things have been done by the parents is somewhere good for them. So in this way, they will like the book and they will enjoy reading books. So in this way, students, we have completed this text, and in the next class we shall be looking for drama, that is Merchant of Venice. There we will be talking on act 2, scene 2 or 3, scene 2 and 3. So student, till that time, thank you so much and have a nice day.